Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches. Director's cut. Blind. A sudden shiver carried down my spine. We've been thinking about starting a fire. I don't know if we should start it in our room or here. I'm thinking of all the places here would be the best, because there's... Well, there's no wood upstairs, is there? I don't think so. Alright, so let's start a fire. Probably need to put the newspaper on there first. No, I guess not. The wood was now burning nicely in the fireplace. An impressive fireplace? Yeah, that's, I read that before. So now what? Should we see if we can go outside? Been a while since I've gone outside. We have keys, or a key we haven't used. Should check the mailbox real quick. The electrician's actually coming for real today, maybe? Okay, the letter's not there, the Italian letter. So it's been taken. I'm assuming, by the postman. That's a rather wild assumption, though, given what's been going on. Padlocked. No way I could get open with my bare hands. What about with a silverish key? Hey, hey. You haven't forgotten these areas. A strong smell of aged oil was infecting the barn-like garage. Oh, you won't let me get that? I need the axe to defend myself. All we have is a kitchen knife. Right, what else is here before we move forward? No. There was an old and dusty bicycle in the garage. It seemed to have some sort of device attached to it. What, that? What device? This? Making use of my limited technical knowledge, I realized that the device had to be a dynamo. Oh. Is this a powered bicycle, then? A dynamo. Okay, well... Do we want that? Can we get it? That was pointless, mister. Oh, just trying random stuff. Clean the dynamo? Oh. I haven't read his notes for a while. Yeah. The hidden room does exist, but I won't be able to get inside through the door. It's been completely bricked off. I have to find another way. Not sure if I read this. The hidden door in the gallery led to a small storeroom. There was a strange mask inside and more mementos belonging to James Blackwood. The developments of his story is really getting into me now. I can almost feel his suffering, and that mask seems to be the key to the mystery. I may be insane, but at least I managed to get inside the room. I don't think I understood yet that I have just risked my life. One wrong step and it would have been fatal. As it turns out, the hidden room belonged to the son of the Blackwood family. I still can't tell why it was bricked off, but I should try and see if he's still around. He may be the only one that can tell me what happened inside this house. I guessed that deep inside myself I knew the reason why, but I had to make sure. The Blackwood son died a long time ago, which is probably the reason why the room was bricked off and left bricked up and left abandoned. The thing that is not clear is whether the child was born dead or died shortly after delivery. Oh, I thought it died shortly after delivery. So, I mean, I knew that right away, because why would they... Like, if the son grew up in the house, they would turn the nursery into his bedroom. It wouldn't remain a nursery. And the fact that it was bricked up like that. Yeah, duh. I knew he wasn't alive. I just wrote a few words for my new book, but I'm far from satisfied. It sounds too much like cheap writing. 10. What's worse, I realized that all this time while I was working, I was in reality thinking about the Blackwood mystery. I guess I'm done for today. The many adventures I have had left me very tired, so I'll be heading back to bed earlier today. I have a premonition, though. I think that tomorrow will be the day I make great progress resolving the Blackwood mystery. I just know it. There's no point to it. I just can't do it. I can't write, at least not until I solve the mystery of Blackwood Manor. Again, the scratching sounds. What could possibly be causing them? I better hurry up and look into this before they stop. Have I just seen a vision? Product of being tired? After all, I'm bound to expect strange occurrences whilst occurring at midnight through a decrepit old house. But the cold sweat on my forehead has brought me to my senses. I know it was very real. Is that after he was in the furnace? I may be insane. I should probably race out of the house and never return. Yeah. But I just want to go back to bed. I need to sleep. Clear my mind a little bit. Perhaps I'm not too tired to realize that I'm not alone in this place. Another day inside Blackwood Manor. Fortunately, the rain has stopped. Somehow, I feel renewed with energy. It's like the past night was just a bad dream. I'm almost doubting it ever happened. But still, I feel strangely optimistic. I have to keep going. I tried sitting at my desk, just one more try, but it was useless. Useless indeed. A small crate was sitting near the bicycle. Can I get inside the crate? I got a hammer. Really? Hammer in the morning. I want inside the crate. You really don't care what's in this crate. Brother. Wait, do I have to be... Maybe I have to be this close. It's not pointless. Wait. Yeah, you can hurt yourself. Alright. Oh, I wanted to look at that. We're done trying the power. One classy and old automobile was aiming at that. Still, I didn't want to get very close as it gave me the strange feeling that something was about to jump at me from inside. Really? Yeah, I wouldn't doubt it. Maybe when you're over here looking at this stuff, it'll jump. Ooh, what'd you get? Screwdriver? Just a generic screwdriver. I wonder what we could use that for. Of all the various items lying on the table, only the toolbox on the far left seemed to have a few useful things. Or one useful thing. Let me just make sure. Oh, wait. Would have missed that. Pliers? A pair of pliers that I had taken. Alright, so we got pliers. Maybe with the pliers we can get the wire off the crypt. Like, I really want to go there. But still, I believe we have to at some point. I do not want to go to the crypt. That's a creepy door sound. Well, I think the greenhouse is this way? I could put off the crypt by going there first. It was hopeless. The rust wouldn't allow this door to be opened. Well, maybe we can help it along. No. Maybe not. Could there be another way in? Can we... Maybe at some point we'll find something to remove rust or something. I don't know. Yeah, I can't see another way. I'm also gonna remove the hinges of the door. Which I don't think. I think the hinges are on the inside. Break the window. Nope. Alright. I guess we have to go to the crib. There's also that tree over there, but I don't see a need to go visit that right now. Or what that might have to do in anything. Maybe she's buried near there? Alright, so if I go here, and then turn... The chapel. Right, we haven't been to the chapel yet either. The key didn't fit there. Yeah. I mean, this key was ready to use for something, so it's probably not gonna, you know. What about this? Have I ever even used this key? I think that's the key to the basement. Nope, key to the basement. And this is the house key. That's not gonna work. Sure, I tried that before. The crypt, we had to go through the house to the side. Out near the basement. Through the kitchen. I tried this one, right? Yeah. You hurt yourself. Let's try to get over there. Can't go that way. Nope, we just have to go back. What are those lights that look like bird cages? Like gothic bird cages. For gothic birds. So we're here. There's the house, but we can't move over there to the side. Well, so the crypt is... The crypt might be back there. Whatever we saw through the furnace might have come from the crypt. Wonderful. Because it's the rear of the house. Is where we're situated. A lot of doors. Of course, here I am, opening all the things that keeps the evil at bay. I've let the mask loose. I've opened the basement so they can just come through there. Huh. This is... Where's the crypt? I remember seeing this before. Right, it was through here. This bridge. And if I have it correctly, the basement would be out this way. Oh, I missed that. Yeah, I'm not very happy to be here. I'm guessing we can use the pliers to get this off, so... I sound so thrilled, don't I? Mm-hmm. A cold shiver ran down my spine as I entered the decaying crypt. The foul smell of rotting flesh seems to have persisted throughout the years. Steps? Oh. I'm gonna see someone, like, pass through the window. Oh, and you can go down there. I couldn't imagine what the purpose of the grating in the floor was. Obviously, nobody down there was in need of fresh air. Yeah, really. The grating in the floor. Catherine Blackwood, here she buried, or here she is buried. According to the plaques, both Mr. and Mrs. Blackwood had died in the same year. Ooh. What's that? Just got a rock or something? I want to see it. An ordinary rock. Oh, we kept the wire. It was the piece of wire that had been holding the doors to the crypt. Because everybody wants a rock to wind the piece of string or the wire around. What are we going to do with a wire? A wire? And I have a scent feeling that we're going to be combining the wire with something. I really want to put it around the rock, as you can see. That's a spooky sound. I'm gonna open it. I seriously considered what I was about to do, but my curiosity got the better of me. Ugh. A corpse in advanced stages of decomposition was inside the coffin. It was disgusting. Whoever that was, I could sense a feeling of terror in its dead face. The body had been resting for several years until my disturbance decided to leave it alone. What about the other coffin? Mrs. Blackwood? Empty. Yep. Curiously enough, this coffin was completely empty. Not happy. I'm not happy. I've made my way into the crypt. The place is suffocating and the rotting smell unbearable. I guess we're supposed to go down. I'm not happy about this. Several candle holders were attached to the walls, but alas, there were no candles in the vicinity. Yeah, funny that. Whoever's down here, or skulking about this place, has, taken off with all the candles. How can we see down here? I guess there's enough light from the grate, I guess. Maybe that's the purpose, to give some light. In case people don't have things like candles. I thought I saw it. Oh. Well, that one's been disturbed. That one's been disturbed. As am I, feeling disturbed. The prospect of witnessing the decaying body of a baby wasn't very tempting. Oh. One of the coffins likely belonged to the dead child of James Blackwood. Well, we could see the name here then, right? Even though it was in better shape than the rest, it was too dark in this particular spot to make out what the plaque read. Well, it says R. Oh, maybe Robin? Because I saw O-B-I-N. So I thought Tobin. So maybe it's going to be Robin Blackwood. Most of the plaques are... Yeah. Seeing one dead body inside the crypt had been enough for me. There were several coffins in this room, probably belonging to the most important ancestors of the family. What happens to the unimportant ones? They get thrown in a ditch somewhere? Can't read that one. Don't want to look in there. This coffin was half opened and I was horrified to glimpse the remains of a dead cat in it. Strange. So we can't read. I mean, I can kind of read it. Ingridson? Fogelson? Maybe Fogelson. Married into the family. That says Alfred B. Blackwood. I can read it! You liar. You're a liar. We got space for another. Coffin. One more coffin. Soon to be filled by myself. I'm a distant relative of the family, unbeknownst to myself, and subject to the mask's curse. Yeah, makes a good story. There's bound to be a twist in the story, so could be that. Let's get the hell out of here. After leaving the crypt, I stopped to think for a few seconds. I only found one body inside, but there were two plaques. Something was evidently out of place here. Leaving the area with great haste. Call, what's his name again? Jerry? I like Jerry, even though he's a greedy, conniving little thing sometimes. Any more notes? I didn't find that much inside the crypt, except that a body was missing. It's likely that both James and Catherine were buried together. In spite of the murder, and I know that Catherine is dead for sure, but James? The plot is thickening. Oh, you know, I assume that was James. So maybe that's his wife. Maybe he's not dead.
Yes?
Hi, Jerry.
Michael, I was worried about you. Are you doing okay?
No.
Yes, I'm fine, and I think I know the identity of my intruder.
Tell me, who is it?
James Blackwood.
The Blackwood person? Michael, are you serious? That the ghost of the murderer is roaming the house?
Maybe not a ghost.
I'm not talking about his ghost, Jerry. I'm talking about him.
What the heck do you mean?
I mean James Blackwood himself, alive, in this house.
What? How is that possible?
It makes sense. After murdering his wife and realizing what he has done, he begs for help to Christopher Milton, who fakes his death.
What does he eat?
Milton, the previous owner? Michael, you're losing your mind. Even if he managed to hide himself, how did he survive all this time? Milton has been missing for years.
Good point, but I'm sure a desperate man like Blackwood would have found a way.
Yes, by turning into a ghost. Wait a minute. Yeah, I have it right here. James Blackwood passed away on June 1963. Would you please stop this?
Jerry, just listen to me. I know I'm right. There's only Mrs. Blackwood's body in the crypt. His is missing.
Oh, God, Michael. You've really gone out of your mind. Digging into coffins, what next? Desecrating the chapel?
I know. Whatever it takes to solve this mystery. You can only find stories like this in books.
Precisely why I'm beginning to wonder about your sanity.
What's that?
You'll see.
Sanity? We don't have no sanity here. We just crawled through a furnace, looked through a crypt at bodies, and we hear scratches in the middle of the night. Gonna be busy. Alright. So he just found a date, which means we can go up and check the newspapers again. I know it's the other way across the house. I just wonder how much turning. That's a different theme. Oh wait, we go up. That's down. We go up this way. Down, down, down. Boom, boom, boom. To the Bat Newspapers! I went through the news during June 1963. The article wasn't as informative as I hoped, but there was a phone number scribbled on the page. Once more from the Journal. Following the shocking news that became of public knowledge last week, we must now inform the sinister outcome of the story that has been in the mind of every citizen of our town these past few days. Mr. James Blackwood has died at the age of 56 due to a heart attack, allegedly because of the pressure and stress caused by the astonishing accusation by Mrs. Eva Mariani, former maid of the family. This puts a sudden end to the case deferred by the authorities. Police Chief William Bailey said, "It saddens me that Mr. Blackwood was never brought to a proper trial. No matter what kind of excuses could be possibly made, the death of Mrs. Catherine Blackwood is a fact. I'm fully convinced that he was guilty." Dr. Christopher Milton is said to be taking care of a funeral that nobody will attend, and all the belongings of the Blackwood family are now in his possession. Maybe it's Christopher still here. Silently, Rothbury returns to daily life, turning the page over one of its darkest chapters. Many will wonder, in the years to come, what really happened inside Blackwood Manor, and here it says Bailey with a number. We might have to manually dial this. Oh, what about the bank? I forgot about the bank. I have their number. Okay, let's just write, I'm writing this now. Bailey. Okay. Mail train robbery went over £1 million. A senior police spokesman said last night that the total haul on yesterday's mail train robbery was clearly well over £1 million. More than £500,000 of it belonging to the National Provincial Bank. All right. What about the sinister presence here? Maybe he lives up here. And just wanders around at night by the crypt. Or outside the house. I hope we don't come across any more people or things wandering around. Yeah, that was kind of a jump scare, wasn't it? Right, so we're heading down to the phone. I want to dial the bank first. Now, it's Monday. The bank should be open. Unless it's a holiday, and that's why what's-her-name Barbara took off. Everything's delayed. Another number. Okay. That's loud. This is the bank number. 01. This is how we did it back in the day, kids. 9 1 2. Oh, it displays on the bottom. Good. 9. So you didn't have this back in the day. It wouldn't display on the bottom of some screen for you. 9 4. 1 4 4. I have the account number as well.
Good day, the National Bank of Northumberland. Robert Blake speaking.
Hello, Robert. I need some help.
I asked about Dr. Christopher Milton.
Do you have a customer there registered as Christopher Edward Milton? He's a doctor.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't give you that kind of information.
Oh, come on.
It's all right. I work in the hospital with him. My name is Dr. Mike Rutherford.
Which hospital would that be, sir?
Rothbury Health and Care Medical Center.
Please hold on a few moments.
Mike Rutherford.
I'm sorry, sir. I see we had someone called that a few years ago, but everything in the files has been removed. It'd seem he's no longer a customer of this bank.
Oh, I see. Good old Christopher still playing pranks on me, that old joker.
Sir, you said your name was...
I won't waste your time anymore. Good day.
This is the guitarist from Genesis. I knew it sounded familiar. Mike Rutherford. Really? I have to dial this over again? Because I want to ask about James now. Well, can we not do that? Do we screw things up? See, now he's on to us. Of course, this is before caller ID. We can just change our voice, right? 01. 9. 1. 2. 9. 4. One, four, four.
What? All right, relax.
How'd you know? There was no caller ID back then. Oh, I want to ask about James, though. What does he say for that? All right, let's dial the... whoever this Bailey is. Six, six, five... Pretty cool. Hello, Bailey?
Who is this?
Smoker?
Hi, are you Mr. William Bailey?
William Bailey.
That's me. And you are?
Yes, my name is Michael Arthade. I'm a journalist for a local newspaper in Rothbury.
Yeah, that's a ticket.
I see. And what's this all about?
Well,
murder.
You're a former police chief of this town, aren't you?
Indeed. I served many years ago.
And you were once in charge of a famous, or should I say, infamous case here?
Bloody hell.
Let me make the connection.
Tell us about James Blackwood.
Well, yes. I'm writing a story for my newspaper. The most famous police cases of Northumberland.
Have you got any idea how many times I've talked about this?
Many?
Go to your nearest library. I'm sure you'll find plenty of information about Blackwood there.
Please, Mr. Bailey, I beg you.
Please, Mr. Bailey, I beg you. It won't be the same if I can have the information from someone who was there, and no less than the renowned William Bailey of Rothbury.
All right, son, spare me the nonsense. What is it you want to know?
Everything.
Well, in the first place, what did Ava Mariani see, exactly?
She saw enough, son. James Blackwood was dragging a shape into a hole in the garden.
Garden.
At first, Mrs. Mariani couldn't realize what it was, but eventually she made out the dead body of Catherine Blackwood with a serious wound.
And Blackwood was automatically deemed guilty?
He was found digging his wife's son.
Why did James Blackwood never appear before a jury?
When you're someone as renowned and famed as James Blackwood was, you can pretty much avoid the authorities. However, you can't avoid justice. And justice was brought upon James Blackwood.
Right. Justice? How?
He died.
He died shortly after the accusation. You should know about that.
We do.
What happened to Dr. Christopher Milton?
Yeah, really?
How should I know? You bet your life that slimy worm was up to something.
Oh.
I couldn't prove it, though I spent years investigating him. A shame we couldn't implicate him as much as James Blackwood.
What
are
you
saying he could have had something to do with the murder?
Blackwood and Milton were very intimate. Milton did the impossible to aid his friend, and even clear his name after he died. You do the math.
Intimate how?
And was ever determined the cause of death of Catherine Blackwood?
Yes, partly. Mrs. Mariani managed to see her throat was slit open. Ripped, she would say. Been horrible for the poor girl.
Still, everything sounds so vague, as if something were missing.
Are you questioning my performance on this case, son?
Sure, why not?
No, sir, not at all. I'm just trying to figure this out. Like, why a proper autopsy was never done?
An autopsy to whom?
Please, sir, this is very important to me, and I could really use your
Catherine?
Help.
Catherine?
I'm trying to fit all the pieces of this mystery together. Don't think I understand, sir.
Listen, son. That cold-blooded bastard murdered his wife, God knows why. But he and his fancy doctor did the impossible to hamper our investigations. You don't have to be a brilliant detective to realize Blackwood did it.
What did the doctor do? There's always a reason behind a murder. There's a motive.
There's always a reason behind a murder. Nobody has ever found out why Blackwood did what he did.
Psychopaths don't need any reasons. And James Blackwood turned into one, precisely.
Well then, tell me how Blackwood reacted when you pulled his wife from beneath the ground.
You didn't.
I beg your pardon.
I mean Catherine Blackwood's
body. He left her there.
You dug in the garden of the manor.
She
like
left
I said,
it there.
They hampered the investigation. We never managed to set one foot inside the manor.
Oh, God, really?
What kind of bloody journalist are you, son?
Well, you didn't tell me that.
But are you telling me you never actually retrieved the body?
Nope.
That's exactly what I'm telling you. Now, if you don't mind.
But wait, this doesn't make any sense.
Stop wasting my time, damn it. I was enjoying my retirement until you had the brilliant idea of calling me. I don't want to hear anything else about this case ever again.
Please, Mr. Bailey, don't...
Leave me alone.
Click. Huh. Jerry? Just talk with the... Nope, okay. Well. Certainly a surprising development. Reading the article about Blackwood's death was almost fruitless, except that there was a phone number on the main page. It would seem like someone was planning to phone Mr. Bailey. I wonder if that call was ever made. I have just spoken with the retired policeman, William Bailey. I can barely believe what I've just heard. Catherine Blackwood is still buried in the garden. But what about Blackwood, then? Wow. Okay. The plot sickens. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Maybe we'll go try to dig her up. We don't have a shovel. We have other stuff. I could try to dig her up with pliers and screwdriver. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.